oh-my-zsh is installed with our basic robbyrussell theme, we're going to take a look at the config file, the zshrc, then we're going to jump into plugins, and there's a lot of them, guys. So these plugins will turn you guys into power users. There's a lot of configuration around the plugins. You can choose whatever ones you want. We're going to get into some of them, and then we're going to finally jump into aliases, and I'm going to show you how to configure that and set that up. Once again, guys, be sure to stick around for the entirety of the video as I give most of my insights towards the end of the lesson. All right, with that being said, let's jump in. As you can see, my terminal's changed a little bit. There's more details in the title. The window's still the same. There's a few other things here. I don't have any aliases, so my ZS command that I use for an alias no longer is applicable. I'm gonna use that, and I'm just gonna jump back over here. And I'll go through this file as best as I can, guys, and I'll cover most of the things. Some things I won't cover because it's just a little bit more beyond the scope of this tutorial. So there is a section for aliases. Here are some example aliases that we could add or unlock or use. So for now, I'm going to paste or control my alias down here. I'm going to say alias. We're actually going to use the alias here. And so what I would like is when I type in ZS, you know, it'll use Visual Studio's code and it'll open up this file and it'll be here. Now you'll see the circle above here to indicate that we haven't actually saved this, right? So if I say, you know, Command S, I can save this, but sometimes it won't actually, you know, happen right away. So you'll have to come over to your terminal and you can source this. So we're gonna source the actual file that we're looking for, which is the zshrc file. And once we do that, then we know that the changes will be fully applied to what we want our alias to be. So let's just see how that works. We'll close this. And then I'm gonna type in ZS. And as you can see, Visual Studio's code will open up the document that is using the alias that I provided towards the bottom here. So as a disclaimer, you know, before we started this, I kind of mentioned in the beginning that you're gonna have to, you know, back up all of your aliases and things and your settings in your original ZSH file or bash file or shell that you have, because it does kind of replace those things. And it'd be kind of, you know, unfortunate if you lost all of your custom aliases and your customization that you did to your, you know, your shell file. There's a couple more I'm gonna add, but you can add as many as you want or whatever you had before, and you can uncheck aliases by just deleting the pound sign. Now, I don't want you guys to panic because some of the things that you've been using, if you go into the terminal, we're gonna source this file one more time again, just to kind of make sure we're accepting our aliases. So if I type me, here comes up my Explorer, that's my shortcut. And so I know that's kind of working. Now, if I type things like Composer, that stuff should still work. Like nothing's really changed in the sense of the paths to where those things are. And notice that I do have an alias for Composer and this is what it's doing. If you don't know where Composer is located, you can type in which Composer, that will give you where it's aliased. I hope that makes sense. So be careful with your aliases and the paths and stuff like that. When things are not working, it's probably because you have to come into the zshrc file and add those paths or add the path to your file. And so when I type in things like Laravel, they should work. When I type in things like Composer, we should be good to go. I do a clear, I do valet. Everything should be working as normal. You shouldn't have any issues. The only thing that's changed is like kind of the aesthetics and the layout of your terminal and a little bit of functionality that we're gonna get into around what's happening inside of this file.
Hey guys, what's up? Kevin here. I just want to give a big shout out to my subscribers. If you haven't already subscribed, please do so. Be sure to give the videos a like, a thumbs up, and start a conversation. Much appreciated. Now let's get back to the video.
Now, I also had something in here before. I was using a Node version manager, something that switches between Node. So like if you have Node.js installed, you should see something like this, or if you have NPM installed, all of these things that we have should be running as they should. So note that if you come from bash up here, you might have to actually put in your path, kind of the same thing down there. I want you guys to understand is we're going to change a bunch of things inside this file. So we have this thing down here called plugins. And if you have Git installed, if you type in Git, you should be able to see all the commands that are available with that. oh-my-zsh comes with a bunch of plugins. So let's open up the browser and we're going to jump to the GitHub repo where the plugins are located. So here we are, we're in oh-my-zsh, the repo, the repository, and it lists all these sorts of plugins. So these are things that you can add for additional functionality to your terminal or to oh-my-zsh. I'm going to show you a few of them. You can go through these on your own time, guys, and pick out ones that are useful for you depending on what you're doing. Like if you're doing something around Docker, or you have something around macOS or Laravel, you can pick the appropriate plugin. But there's some common kind of useful ones that you'll just want out of the gate that I actually kind of prefer, and you know, you may find it useful. We're going to head down to the bottom and we're going to take a look at one called z. Okay. So this plugin defines a Z command and it tracks your most visited directories and allows you to access them. I like this plugin. It does a lot of really cool things, but as you get more familiar with terminal and you start doing a lot more functionality, this will come in handy. You can choose whether you want to install that or not. I'm going to install it. And I'm going to jump to this one here called Laravel. We use Laravel a lot on this channel. You can use this to kind of help you with some of the aliases. You don't have to do this, but you can add this plugin if you'd like as well. And it tells you a lot of the things that you can do. And it adds a lot of auto completion for Laravel. Back in the repository, there's another one I like to use called macOS, just depending. So we'll just minimize this for a moment. We'll go back to our terminal. Every once in a while, you may notice that like you have to like push up or down to cycle through commands. You can't actually even tell if those commands are actually official commands or paths, or you know, you don't have any kind of IntelliSense to help you figure that out. We can go over here and you can add the ones that are appropriate for you and your situation and your environment. You know, give them a read and see if it makes sense. So you need a space. I'm going to add Laravel. I'm going to add macOS. I'm going to add this other one and I'm going to add Z. Now, you can add as many as you want or as few as you want, and you can remove them in the same way they're added. So I'm going to save this. And once again, I'm going to source my zshrc file. So I'm going to go tab up till we hit that command, or you could type it out. I'm just being lazy here. It says this is not found, and that's good. And that's because we haven't provided that. And if you notice, when we opened up our browser, you know, auto suggestions not in the list. So what we'll have to do is we'll have to add the repository for that. Now I'll provide you the links for these guys in the description. So be sure to check that out and you'll see what it is that you need to do. So we're going to scroll down to the bottom here and it kind of gives you like some basic instructions of how to install this, right? So the one that we're looking for, we're going to take this command here. Okay. Minimize our browser and we're going to run this. Okay. So now when we run or we try to source our zshrc file, we'll see that we don't get the error anymore because we pulled that piece of software down from the repository and we've added it to our project or to our terminal. So now if I do just a clear, you type in clear. I like CLS, but notice what it's doing right now. As I'm typing, it's starting to suggest what it thinks I mean to complete, right? That's what auto suggestions does. It knows my aliases. It knows the things that are inside of this file, right? And I've added it here as a plugin. But if I go down to the bottom here, it'll see that it knows that, you know, these are here, plus the additional plugins and commands that I've already, you know, installed. You can do, you know, command K to kind of clear that. But if you type in clear, it'll also try to suggest the commands that are available in terminal. So that way I don't have to really kind of cycle up and down through this stuff, right? As long as the commands and the path are legitimate or exist, it'll try to help you and, you know, help complete that. So let's say I type in source and there it goes. It starts to say, was these one of the last commands you were using? And it wants me to complete that. So you just hit forward on the arrow and it'll do that. And once again, that's done. If I do like, say like a PWD, now let's say I want a CD. I've used these commands like tilde that brings you home to root. If you're not familiar with any of these commands or they seem confusing, guys, do check out the terminal series. It'll get you caught up. There's going to be some more advanced stuff around that, but for now, just try to follow along if you can. And so I want to CD into my projects directory. So this is where I keep some stuff where I'm working on with things for you guys. Notice that the highlighting is a little bit different. It's got some color behind the actual terminal. Right. So if I do an ls, so if I change directories and I say we're going into, you know, some stuff we're doing around the HTML, it nicely completes that for you. So it literally tries to make your life easier and it'll try to think of what you're trying to say when you're completing a command. If you're going to use oh-my-zsh, this one's highly recommended.
Just to let you know, there will be more lessons in the series. So don't forget to click the notification bell and get informed when the new lessons in the series drops. Thanks again, guys. Take care of yourselves and I will see you guys next time.